Live from the Hirsch Coliseum in Shreveport, Louisiana, it's the 1997 Miss USA pageant.
Now let's get started with our first competition, George.
Thank you, Marla. It is now my distinct pleasure to talk with 10 of the most beautiful women in the world. Now, I have been rehearsing my whole life for this. We asked the delegates to bring along videos to give us a look at their lives back home, and we'll see these clips as we meet them. Let's begin the interview competition with Miss Florida. Say hello to Miss Florida. She's a 25-year-old nursing student from Jacksonville who enjoys, among other things, scuba diving and playing with her 80-pound puppy, Sasha. Ladies and gentlemen, Angelia Savage, Miss Florida. Now, that dog is as big as you are.
She most certainly is. She is my pride and joy. I actually won her in a fitness contest, and I think she's the one that keeps me fit now.
Well, boy, she is big. Now, let me ask you this. You're studying nursing. What are you specializing in?
Actually, I plan to specialize in pediatric aides. That's something that's very dear to my heart, and I plan on pursuing that career later. I'm a junior right now at Jacksonville University in Florida.
So you are a title holder, and a lot of people take the attitude that in title holding you just get sashes and crowns and that sort of thing. You don't do community service. Tell me some of the things you've done.
Oh, I have done so many great things since I've become Miss Florida USA. I think the most exciting that I did was MC a pageant for a nursing home. And I had all of the elderly young ladies that had their families come in, and they got all dressed up and had makeup on and beautiful as they could be. And I asked them questions individually, and we just had a really great time. And I think that was very inspiring.
Well, inspiring for us to hear that. Angelia Savage, Miss Florida, please go into your scoring mark. And now let's get to know Miss Rhode Island, an inspiring journalist. She's covered the Million Man March in Washington and recently helped organize anti-violence rally in her own community. Miss Claudia Jordan, Miss Rhode Island. Now, would you call yourself in that video a community activist? Are you a community activist?
Well, ever since I won the title, I found that doors were opening a lot easier so I can get things done that I've always wanted to do. When I was 17, I had lost a friend that was close to me to gun violence, so I took it upon myself to go into the community and try to discourage violent acts with guns and to try to encourage alternatives to violence.
Sounds great. Now, let me ask you this. What about your family? What's your family background?
I'm half Italian and half black, and all of my family, all of my mom's side is in Italy, my father's side is in the United States, so I'm a black Italian.
So you're a black Italian. You have a foot on both sides of the Atlantic, don't you?
I got the best of both worlds.
What's next for you in your career?
Well, right now I'm a professional model, and I also am a journalist for the Providence American newspaper when I have time. Right now I'm really busy with the modeling, and I hope to continue that as, you know, I have opportunities now, so I want to follow through with that. And when that kind of dies down as I get older, I would really like to take off with the journalism and the broadcasting career and possibly try some acting.
Thank you, Miss Rhode Island. Please go over to your scoring mark. Claudia Jordan. Now let's meet Miss Alabama. She's 22 years old, has a degree in interior design, and now works for her father's construction business. Please sit down. Ladies and gentlemen from Chelsea, Alabama, meet Autumn Smith. Autumn, now in that video, I saw what you were doing. You were driving a Bobcat, am I correct?
Yes, you are.
Now, is that like a sports car where you come from?
No, not at all. What we were doing is, my father owns a drywall business, and we're building a new office complex, so I was picking dirt, you know.
Are there other boys in the family, or is it just you you're doing it?
I have two older brothers, but they're not near as good as I am working the Bobcat.
Now, are you your dad's favorite? Is he tough on you, or is he easy on you?
Yeah, I work for my father, and what I do is I'm a drywall estimator, so we get the blueprints in, and I figure out the square footage, but, you know, everyone thinks that working for your father would be really easy, and It's tough. He is hard on me. So, but he did let me off for the 2 weeks to come here, but he's like, you're gonna make up for it when you get home.
Okay, thank you. Miss Autumn Smith, Miss Alabama. Right over your scoring mark, please. Now say hello to Miss Oklahoma, a junior majoring in pharmaceutical research. She enjoys spending her leisure time playing outdoors. Ladies and gentlemen, from Edmond, Oklahoma, Trisha Stillwell. Now, in your video, I saw you playing with your nephew. You sound like you look like you were having more fun than your nephew.
Well, yeah, we have a lot of fun. My nephew teaches me some tricks of the trade and really is a football buff, so he's a huge Dallas Cowboys fan.
You're into pharmaceutical research, right? Now, what are you going to do after you get your degree?
When I get my degree, I plan on going into pharmaceutical research, focusing on migraine headaches. I've had migraines since I was 13 years old, so that's something that is very close to me and something that, you know, I want to find a cure for because I know the hassles and the problems that it causes.
Are we close to a cure?
We're close to a lot of things that are alleviating symptoms, but we're not too close to a cure yet.
Well, thank you so much. Right over to your scoring mark there. Miss Trisha Stillwell from Oklahoma, Miss Oklahoma. All right, now let's meet Miss Utah. She's 21-year-old university student and model who aspires to a career in country music. From Centerville, Utah, say hello to Temple Taggart. Now, in your video, tell me what you were doing there.
Well, I believe that I was on a sky coaster. It's something that you're strapped to a cable, takes you 180 feet up in the air, drops you 150 feet, and catches you at 30 feet above the ground.
Are you an adventuresome person, or you just did that as a crazy moment?
I am. I'm really adventurous. I like to try all different kinds of things, so.
Well, also, you have a serious side. What does your family do? What do you all do together?
We love to rent movies and get Oreos and milk and sit around the fireplace and have some fun.
That's what you do with your family?
Well, we do lots of different things. I wrestle with my brothers sometimes, have arm wrestling competitions, so.
You probably win, don't you?
I do. I wish I could, actually, but I'm working on it.
All right, now, I want to ask you one other thing. I'm told that you want to be a country singer. Is that true? Am I wrong about that?
That is true.
All right, now, I know it's part of our history here. We're just going to harass you until you do it. Would you just give us a couple of bars? Ladies and gentlemen, what do you say? Come on. Come on, stand over here in your mark. Temple Taggart, Miss Utah.
Any man of mine better be proud of me. Even when I'm ugly, he still gotta love me. I can be late for a date, that's fine, but he better be on time.
Thank you. Temple Taggart, Miss Utah, right over your scoring mark, please. Thank you all, ladies. We'll talk to the remaining five semifinalists in a few moments.